Hi, it's Vince with Bait Pal again, and we're here to introduce our new Paddler's Pal. We've asked one of our local fishermen here to come out today and bring his kayak so we could actually show how everything fits up. Of course, Paddler's Pal, like everything else, will be available on our website, www.baitpalproducts.com. So let's go ahead. I've got one out now. We'll go ahead and show you guys how it sets up. What we have is a system that uses our pals and actually uses a rubber cord system that will attach to pretty much any kayak, canoe, whatever you want to attach to. What you're going to want to do is really just get it around your top part of your kayak, bring it around to the back. What I like to do is I try to cinch a little bit extra. You fasten it tight and pull it down into your kayak's gunnel groove. Is that what you call that?
I think that's what I'd call it.
So as you can see, the Bait Pal lanyards are set up with two separate O-rings. What we have it set in right now is the inside, or the bottom O-ring, which is basically inside. It allows the Bait Pal to flip to the inside. Everything stays vertical. It allows you to access whatever you're carrying, bait, hooks, whatever you want to carry in them. Todd has this side set up here, and as he likes to set it up, a lot of them hang off the front where it makes everything accessible. Bait Pal is easily convertible to all my different containers. This is our standard trio, as you'll notice, and this is one of our small PB containers. Pops right off. Right on, and you're fishing. Same way with our catfish pal, which actually holds all your catfish nuggets. Everything's universal and mounts to each other. So what we're going to do now is I think Todd's going to put this in the water and see how it works out. All right, well, we're in the water. He's got everything hooked up. Todd, what do you think?
Seems like it's pretty functional right now. Flipping them in, they're tucking right out of the way, really not interfering with anything you're doing inside. Again, flip them out. It seems like everything's ready to point of contact. Actually, had them tucked under there just because I had my paddle in, but seems like pretty functional at this point.
Think this would be an easy way to carry bait, hooks?
Absolutely.
Anything you need to access quickly?
Yep, I mean, definitely. I mean, here we are. I'm ready to rig something up, bait right here. Really on this kayak, that's about the only storage you got. If you sit in these things all day long and stuff's in your way, it drives you crazy. You're actually sore by the end of the day trying to compensate or move around for the stuff.
Everything stays out of the way, your legs in, it's not going to be like your legs lean against it or anything?
Yeah. Like I said, they're tucking right in under the wall. But to this side, you can actually see how it's
all right.
It's tucking right in.
Now, outside, it still rides above your waterline pretty good then.
Yeah, it seems like it. Now, a lot of times, like I said, we're gearing up, so we'll be close. And we get in, you know, some faster waters and things like that. Again, it's not going to hurt it if we get in the faster water, but I'm going to go out and paddle up once and down twice to see how they
good deal
setting out.
So he's got good paddle space. Not interfering with his paddles, everything's watertight, just like all the Bait Pal containers, keeps everything wet and dry when needs to be dry.
Let me get set still here.
See, I like the idea that they can move inside and out.
Yeah, definitely like the idea that they can move inside. I mean, if you're running live bait, and you know, some bait doesn't do so well in the sun or hot weather, so you can tuck them in, they actually tuck under the gun wall. And you know, they're kind of out of sight, out of mind, and they're definitely not getting sun where it's going to ruin your live bait. So again, I think it's very functional. You're going to, you know, for this style, you're not going to use them from here to here.
Right. You want them up there where it's accessible.
Yep. So in the same way, you can just switch out containers if you have them tucked back here.
You know, I was telling in my package, it lists where you can actually cut that down to length.
Could you see yourself cutting that to length within the back? You've got a few extra strings hanging out there.
You're talking this rubber?
Yeah, the rubber cord.
Yeah. Probably not for myself, just because I have multiple boats.
So oh,
I can see myself leaving it long for this style, and then when I transition to my other boat, it would that way I could
continue to use it
without issue.